Today we're going to talk about iambic pentameter. Hey, today we're going to... Hey guys, it's Sarah. Welcome back. This is iambic pentameter number 2. What should an actor do with it? If you don't know what iambic pentameter is, click here. Shakespeare was one of the greatest writers of all time, and he layered in many clues for actors, in some ways making it foolproof. Looking at how he used stressed and unstressed syllables can give you tremendous insight into the character you're playing. We could seriously do an entire year-long course on this one topic, but there are all kinds of clues to look for in the iambic. Let's say you're preparing one of Romeo's famous speeches from Romeo and Juliet for an upcoming audition. If you have college auditions in your future, you definitely want to listen up. Here are the first two lines of text from Romeo's most famous monologue, all punctuation removed. Here's one way to scan it. Scansion is simply the action of scanning a line of verse looking for the stresses. First line, straightforward, but the second line starts to mix it up. Here's how I scanned it. What do you notice? Well, first, in order to get 10 syllables, you discover you must make Juliet's name 2 syllables instead of 3. So it's Juliet instead of Juliet. Second, the way I chose to stress the syllables or to scan it, it doesn't really look like regular iambic. It doesn't really look like regular ba-dum, ba-dum, ba-dum. So what does this mean? Why didn't he take out the second is? He doesn't really need it for the line to make sense, and then her name wouldn't have come out so funky. And the way I chose to scan the first part, what's up with the part where it goes, it is the, there's no stress at all. Did Shakespeare mess up? This is where it gets really fun for the actor. Since Shakespeare's been dead over 400 years, we can't really go back in time and ask him what was intended for each line of verse, but instead, we get to play detective and take a look at the trail of breadcrumbs that he left behind. Sometimes the line isn't a perfect 10 syllables, or sometimes it seems like the stresses are in weird places, like that last example I gave you. These are all opportunities to take a look at what's going on for the character in this moment. Using our example and knowing the story, what could be going on for Romeo? When I look at that line of text, I see an irregular heartbeat, right? If iambic is a heartbeat, ba-bum, ba-bum, I see an irregular one. What if, as Romeo gazes upon his love, his heart actually skips a beat because he's so excited? What do you see when you look at it? Let's next see how this helps you speak your text. It's kind of addicting. Iambic pentameter.